less than 2 miles south of the United States Capitol. Welcome to Nationals Park. MLB The Show has interleague action for you this afternoon. It's the Toronto Blue Jays and the Washington Nationals. Joined by my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Shombe. Well, Singy, when you consider the top hitters ballparks in the sport, this has got to be one of them.
I'll say this. Pitchers have to stay with their game. They can't look over their shoulder and think, I have to be fine and perfect on every pitch. Continue to pitch to your strengths, and you'll come out of here with a good outing.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So, almost ready to get underway, and today's starting pitcher, Jake Irvin. What do we need to know here?
Big-time arm power. One thing he struggles with, though, is repeating his delivery. And sometimes you have bigger pitchers trying to sync things up. Not as easy as a more compact pitcher. But if he can get command going, establish it early, and carry it through the ball game, he's going to pitch deep into this one.
Here's a 1-1. And there's a ball. And the righty deals. Right through there for a strike. Way high. Right-hander kicks, deals. And a foul ball, he stays alive. We'll see another payoff pitch. And the right-hander deals. That one misses, so a leadoff walk. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat.
Now, this is a story we were paying attention to before the game. We've seen him give up walks in the past, and it's an issue once again early on.
Here's Vladimir Guerrero Jr. The 1-1 is fouled off. The pitch. Gets a piece and stays alive. Just off the inside corner, and the count's even at 2.
Typically, that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
Bo Bichette up to the dish. The 1-1 is fouled off. Next pitch is outside.
Really good take, especially with 2 strikes.
Springer, the base runner at first with 1 out. Pickoff throw. It's low and gets away. Left field. Rosario makes the play. Let's take a look at the lineup for the Blue Jays. Justin Turner now. First inning, and already up to 23 pitches. Mm-hmm. spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Good eye right there.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Hammers that one deep left field, and forget it. A gigantic blast. It's 2-0. That was blasted.
Absolutely, no doubt off the bat. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Base is empty with two away, and now it's Dalton Varsho. Two outs. That's in there. 1-2. And a pitch. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Two outs, base is empty. Fouls it back with two strikes. The pitch. Out towards left center. And it falls. And that keeps the inning going.
Batting fifth, the catcher, number 9.
Danny Jansen ahead here.
Jansen.
The 1-1. That's to third. Senzel slings it across. That ends the frame. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. And it's 2-0. Back in Washington, D.C., getting the nod in this one, Kevin Gausman.
Four-pitch guy, he's got some options to work with in terms of keeping hitters off balance. So we'll see how he decides to utilize those weapons through this start here and whether or not he's able to mix them all in early or if he wants to hold something back a little bit later, maybe second, third time through the order, and give them something they haven't seen. It's tough when you know a guy's got that in his back pocket. As a hitter, you really have to stay on your toes.
Foul back our way, and that's out of play. The pitch. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Here's Jesse Winker. One down, base is empty. Late on that fastball.
One ball, two strikes.
That's off the mark, and the count is even, 2-2.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch, keep the at-bat alive.
At the belt and fires. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
The 2-2 on the way. Just missed. Makes the grab, and there's two gone.
Batting third.
As we take a look at the Nationals lineup. So now the DH spot, Joey Meneses.
He's not the power guy, but he can hurt you to all parts of the ballpark.
To third. And that one handled. Nats go down 1-2-3. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. Second inning coming up from our nation's capital. Blue Jays 2 and the Nationals nothing. Back here in Nationals Park, and stepping in, the rookie left fielder, Addison Barger. Here's a 1-1. And a seed into center, that's a base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
All over that one right there.
That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Isaiah Kiner-Falefa up to the plate. Now this is in the air down the line. And that lands at no man's land, a foul ball. In the air, foul off first. Lipscomb drifts towards it, makes the catch, and there's one away.
Batting up, the second baseman, Kevin
Biggio. Kevin Biggio up to the plate. This guy who grew up in big league clubhouses, got to be a nice feeling, Siggy, when your father played the big leagues and he passes down all that wisdom. And a base hit. Just kind of sliced that one into center. They fired it quickly, so it's first and second with only one away. So the batting order turns over. Now here's the leadoff man for the Blue Jays, George Springer. The next pitch misses. Two balls and a strike. That's inside. Runners at first and second with one gone here at the top of the second. Roll to short, could be two. On to first. That takes care of Springer.
That was a productive at bat. You know you're doing something right anytime you help move two runners into scoring position and give your team a chance to drive in a few runs, even if it's still kind of early in the game.
Vladimir Guerrero Jr. now. Barger at third. Biggio on at second with two down. And that one fouled off. Fights it off, you'll see another. And another ball. Jays leave a pair. They're up 2-0. We head to the bottom of the second, and now up for Washington, Luis Garcia. Next pitch is outside. The pitch. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
And another ball.
2-1.
That one fouled off. 2-2.
A little tardy on that fastball. He's going to have to get it going a little quicker. Get that front foot down.
Runner at first with no outs here. This is off the inside, and it's 3-2. Looking, and that's the first out.
Well, just a beautiful fastball on the inside corner for that backwards K right there. I think the hitter saw it all the way coming from that opposite arm angle. So I got to think he was looking away and just got locked up by the hard stuff boring in on his hands.
Here's Eddie Rosario. Puts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Well, pitchers have become so much better at commanding that high fastball. It used to be that a lot of pitchers didn't like to throw it because it threw off their release point and their mechanics, and they're aimed at keeping everything at the knees, get ground balls. But because hitters get a swing path that can lift balls at the knees up in the air and over the fence, this pitch has come back into play, and they are doing some special things with it.
The Nationals down by a pair, bottom half of inning number two. Check swing on the 2-2, appeal to first, and he won around. Not an easy call there, but that puts an end to the inning. Nationals leave one, and they're down 2-0. Top half of the third inning, and now for the Jays, Bo Bichette. The wind and the pitch. And that one is in the dirt. 2-1. And that's in for a strike. Misses off the play. And it's 3-2. And he walked him.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Here's Justin Turner.
Very dominant with that fastball inside. Hitter's going to be conscious of that. Now you have the outer half of the plate to work with out there on the mound.
2-2 on the way. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Dalton Varsho getting ready to hit. Swung on, popped up left side. Snags it for the second out.
Now that the catcher, Danny Jansen.
Now it's Jansen to hit. Bichette off of first with two away.
Two balls, one strike.
And a 2-1 on the way. That clips a corner. That's a little bit low. And And a pitch. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner in the scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
Addison Barger next up for the Blue Jays. Two outs, a couple of base runners at first and second. Swing and a miss, and that is that. Blue Jays leave a pair, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, number 30. And here it comes. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Looks like he's picked up right where he left off.
Man, I really like the ability to bounce back right there after not getting the call. He probably should have gotten. Didn't let it affect his focus. And he came back with another good pitch to get him swinging.
Now it's the rookie first baseman, Trey Lipscomb. And that one lifted in the air center field. Varsho moving under it. Two down.
The batter, number five, shortstop.
So the Nats lineup turns over. Here's C.J. Abrams to hit. The 1-1.
Aye.
A swing and a miss, and it's a 3-up, 3-down inning. Nationals go quietly. They trail it here 2-0. Welcome back, and now on the mound to start the fourth, Derek Law.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
Now the third baseman, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
The third baseman, number seven, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
Garcia to first, one up, one down.
Now back, the second baseman, Kevin Biggio.
Now it's the second baseman, Kevin Biggio. Bunting for a hit. Bare hand scoop, and he beats it. That's a hit. Great try there.
This was the perfect spot to drop the bunt for a hit. I mean, he used his bat as a tool up there to direct the ball exactly where he wanted it to go and look smooth doing it at the same time. Really well done, and the defense right there stood no chance.
To the leadoff spot in the Blue Jays lineup, and it'll be George Springer to step to the plate. And that's outside. 2-1. Biggio leads off first with one away. Righty to the plate, and okay. It's filled up. And he deals. Got him swinging.
Well, that slider down and away, it's just kind of a slow death. For two strikes, you're looking to protect, and halfway to the plate, you know you've committed, and you know you're going to have no chance of touching it. Tell you what, sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
And here's the first baseman, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Swing and a miss, chased it out of the zone.
One ball, two strikes.
Thank you. The 1-2. Swing, and that ball smashed out of line. Rosario right there to make the grab. And that is that. One left for Toronto, but they're on top 2-0. And we're back, ready to go, bottom four. Up now for Washington, Jesse Winker. So now 1-2.
1-2.
Lined in the left center, and that should be extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. And it's a leadoff double for their first hit of the game.
Everything came together for him. I love the approach he had right there with that pitch. Not trying to do too much, but still looking to drive it. And that's exactly what he's able to do into the opposite field gap for the double.
So now here's the DH, Joey Meneses. Man at second.
Helpful.
Here comes a pitch. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. He swings and hits a fly ball. Center field. He's got it. And there's one away.
The batter, number two, second baseman, Luis.
And now it's Luis Garcia. And a pitch. Swing, and this one's bounced to the ground. Fires over to Guerrero, and they get the out.
Up next, the catcher, Kiefer.
And now it's Kiefer Ruiz.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
That one hooked foul. Two outs and a runner at third. We're here at the bottom of the fourth. So one left for Washington. They're still down. It's 2-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. Top five, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Bo Bichette. And now 2-1. Swings and sends a rocket to right. Winker makes the grab, one away.
The bat number two, designated hitter, Justin Turner.
Turner climbs in on that right side. Base is empty, one away, and we're at the top of the fifth.
Ball.
Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Matt Barnes, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. Floro getting loose as well. And that's a base hit into left field. So a man aboard now with one away.
Well, that was one of those high-percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
So up next, Dalton Varsho. Next offering is in for a strike. Right-handed reliever. Swings and misses. Struck him out.
Oh, really went aggressive in with that slider. Good two-strike pitch right there. Yeah. At worst-case scenario, it's weak contact in play. Exactly where he and the catcher wanted it.
On the ground at first, Lipscomb. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one left. Last half of the fifth coming up. Blue Jays 2 and the Nationals nothing. Back in Washington, D.C., we head to the bottom of the fifth. Now the left fielder, Eddie Rosario. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that's the first out.
Save that mid-90s fastball until the final pitch of the at-bat. So at the plate, he hadn't really had a good opportunity to time things up. By the time the pitch was recognized and the swing came through the zone, fastball was in the catcher's mitt.
Now it's Nick Senzel. One down, base is empty. And that's outside. Kicks and fires. In the air, right field. Sizes this one up. They got it for out number two.
The bat. The center fielder.
And now the center fielder. The Jays leading by two. Last half of inning number five. The 1-1 is fouled off.
Looking sharp, just a strike away from five shutout innings.
The pitch. And down on strikes he goes. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Nothing doing for Washington. They trail things here 2-0. Back here in Nationals Park, all set for the top of the sixth. And now for the Jays, Addison Barger. The 1-1 is fouled off. The wind of the pitch. And now it's even up.
Two balls, two strikes.
Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. In the air, left field. And out number one on the grab.
Now batting the third baseman.
Here's the third baseman, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. One one now. And that one is inside. One out, base is empty.
Three balls, one strike.
And that clips the inside corner.
The count's full.
Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Two down.
The batter number eight, second base, Kevin Biggio.
So two down now, and here is Kevin Biggio. Two down, nobody on, and we're in the top half of the sixth.
That's a ball.
Down on strikes, and a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. Three up, three down that time. 9-1 and 2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. Blue Jays 2 and the Nationals nothing. And we're back. Leading and now the first baseman, Trey Lipscomb.
The first baseman, Trey Lipscomb.
At the ball.
And a big swing and a miss. That's to third, Connor Falefa. One away, bottom of the sixth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Next to hit for the Nats, C.J. Abrams. The Blue Jays holding on to a two-run lead here in the bottom of the sixth.
That's ball three.
Definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
Bounce to the right, and that chance handled. And he takes it himself for the out.
The right fielder, number six, Jesse Winker
digging in for the Nationals. Two down, nobody on. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Left-hand hitter waits. That one almost got him. Two two now. There's a line drive to left field. He dives, but can't hang on. That's a base hit, and that extends the inning.
Now that dominant performance for him today, Boo. Just two hits allowed so far, no runs across either, and he's had an answer for just about every hitter he's faced. So I don't think this hit is going to knock him off his stride too much.
Joey Meneses digging in for the Nationals. Two outs, and there's a foul ball. High in the air, out to right. Pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And the inning is over. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Matt Barnes.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Here's George Springer to start it off.
The right fielder, number four, George Springer.
And the pitch. The other way. Oh, he gloves it.
Great diving catch on the line drive, and the ground does not cause a fumble. Great athleticism on that play right there.
So digging in, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. And another ball. One down, base is empty. Nope, that one off the mark, and now 3-1. Activity in the Washington bullpen. Jordan Weems looks to be getting ready for Dave Martinez. Right-hander kicks, deals. Foul ball. And there's ball four.
Up next to the Blue Jays, the shortstop, Bo
Bichette.
And next for Toronto, Bo Bichette. And the righty deals. On the ground, could be two. To second, Abrams. And that's two. Nothing across here this half. Midway in inning number seven, and it's time to stretch. Blue Jays two, and the Nationals nothing. And welcome back to the ballpark. Here's the second baseman, Luis Garcia.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
On the inside corner for a strike. Action in the pen down there. Jimmy Garcia, the hard-throwing righty, is up and loosening. Swanson warming up as well. Back to work, 3-2 now. Stays alive. That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
Well, it might be time to dig into that bullpen. He's looking a little fatigued to me.
Here's the catcher, Hebert Ruiz. The tying run at the plate. Swing and a pop-off in foul ground. And there's one down.
The left fielder, number 8, Eddie Rosario.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Kevin Gausman makes way, and he was very good. They'll be happy with that, no doubt. We'll be back with a new pitcher in a minute. Out of the bullpen for the Jays, Genesis Cabrera.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
So up next, Eddie Rosario.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is, I want to stay square to the plate, to try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
Tying run at the plate. Swings over the top of that one. That ball is foul, and the pressure is building. Two two now. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Two out.
Well, I think he was waiting on the changeup right there, and he got it. It just drifted too far in on him. I think that pitch is just a little more out over the plate. Probably squares it up, but instead, he's going to have to go take a seat.
Nick Senzel digging in for the Nationals. And a 1-1.
That's ball two. Two balls, one strike.
Indians. Swing and a miss. Adam out front for the strikeout. Back in Washington, D.C., now it's the DH, Justin Turner. And a pitch.
That's a ball.
The pitch. That's
ball
down three. And in.
Three balls, one strike.
Out out towards right center field, sizing this one up. Puts it away for the out.
The center fielder, number 25, Dalton.
So up next for Toronto, Dalton Varsho. Ball to strike.
Two balls, one strike.
Wouldn't That's chase that time. On the ground That's to the left. And foul ball. Payoff pitch. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss at the splitter, and it's a strikeout.
That's about as nasty of a splitter as you'll come across, especially in terms of movement. I mean, that thing tumbles out of his hand and just drops off the table at the last moment. If he keeps it down, it's just so tough to put wood on.
Swings through that one for strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Two down, nobody on. On its way to the corner. Winker heads towards it. Won't get to this one. It drops foul. And the right-hander deals.
Outside,
and another ball. At the belt and fires. Popped up to the left into foul ground. And a foul ball. Two down, nobody on. And we're in the top of the eighth. Next ball, offering down strike. Low and in the dirt. Out to center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that's the third out. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Yimi Garcia.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Leading up,
here's the center fielder.
The center fielder.
The pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And a pitch. Struck him out looking.
Well, he's going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. That was his third strikeout, and this one looking, obviously, so he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there at the plate.
The 2-1. And there's the strike. And here it comes. And that's in the dirt. Gets a piece and stays alive. Base is empty, one away. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Foul ball, he stays alive. And that's ball four. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
Abrams. And the batter will be the shortstop, C.J. Abrams. Tying run at the plate. Got him swinging. And there's two away.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
Now it's Jordan Romano out of the bullpen. He has a great slider with tons of movement. And now up for Washington, Jesse Winker. The 1-1 is fouled off. Now move to first.
He's
back standing. Here's a 1-2. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Two outs. Runner on the go. Fights it off. He'll see another. Pitch misses there. 2-2. Struck him out looking. Fastball at the letters froze him for strike three. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Dylan Floro.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
And now for the Jays, Addison Barger.
The left fielder, Addison Barger.
Back to the mound, and it finds its way through for a hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
The third base is number 7.
And next for Toronto, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Here's a 1-1. And another ball. One now. The Nationals have some action going in the pen. Jordan Weems looks to be getting ready for Dave Martinez. Nobody out, runner at first. Pitch. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And a strikeout for the first out here in the ninth. Now so up next for Toronto, Gavin Biggio. The count 2-1. And that's a base hit. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
Solid swing from start to end, on time with everything, really good balance, nice extension, and he met it out front for the line drive knock.
And the batter is George Springer. And that's in there at the knees.
One ball, two strikes.
Runners at first and second with one gone. Two on, one out. Chases that one out of the zone. That's the second out.
Definitely made him chase a little bit out of the zone right there. I don't think that's a strike if he takes it. Pretty textbook pitching. Get ahead in the count, get the guy in the box on his heels, and then force him to chase your pitch where he doesn't have much of a chance to do any damage.
So first and second with two outs. And now for the Jays, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Swing and a pop-up. Lipscomb under it. Nabs it, and that'll do it. Blue Jays leave a pair as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Last chance for the home team. And here's the DH for Washington, Joey Meneses. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. And it's one and two. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Righty delivers, and downstairs. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Wow, just great bite to that slider. Broke hard out of the zone, and he just couldn't hold up the swing. You know, as a hitter, that pitch is really hard to take, and there's just not much you can do with it. You know that, but you don't want to get rung up by the umpire.
Luis Garcia digging in for the Nationals. One down, base is empty. That one fouled off. That one missed. The Jays up by two here in the last half of inning number nine. The punch out there. Now only one out remaining. So the bullpen doing a nice job backing up the effort from their starter.
Yeah, we've seen some pretty excellent pitching out of this staff so far. I mean, they've come in ready to do their job and get outs. They've been pretty tough to get to in this one.
Right-handed reliever. That one's in there, and the count is one and two. Two-run game, a two away here in the bottom of the ninth. Swing and a miss, and he got him. That's the ball game.
Well, someone from the bullpen had to come in, get a big out, and then had a little time to think about it before he went back out to get the final three outs of this ball game. Nonetheless, outstanding job to get the save and secure the win for his team.
2-0, your final here in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Fans, our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Blue Jays, two runs on eight hits, no errors. They left 10 runs.